Launching a web front-end stack is the next step in deploying a SharePoint website in the Amazon Web Services cloud. You should already have launched the network, Active Directory, database, and application stacks for SharePoint, as demonstrated in the previous videos in this series. This video shows you how to launch the SharePoint web front-end server stack using a CloudFormation sample template. The template is a text file with a .json file extension written in JavaScript object notation, or JSON. The AWS CloudFormation service uses the information in it to create a stack of resources. Launching this stack creates a web tier on top of the previously deployed networking, Active Directory, database, and application infrastructure, and joins the web front-end servers to the domain. The web stack completes the installation of the SharePoint server farm infrastructure. The process deploys two Windows Server 2008 R2 EC2 instances, one per web tier in each availability zone, and installs SharePoint Server 2010 for Internet Sites Enterprise on them. Each instance will host Microsoft Internet Information Servers and SharePoint Web Front-End Servers. It also deploys and configures an Elastic Load Balancer to balance traffic between the WFE servers. You have to provide your own license key or get a trial PID key from Microsoft for a trial or test installation. The details of all these procedures are spelled out in the companion document. Before launching the stack template, look up and record the following IDs in the Virtual Private Cloud Console for input into the template: VPC ID, WFE Server Security Group ID, Domain Member Security Group ID, WFE1 Server Subnet ID, WFE2 Server Subnet ID, DMZ1 subnet ID, DMZ2 subnet ID, and Load Balancer Security Group ID. Launch the web stack with sample template 4 by mousing over the Launch Stack button in the companion document and clicking the US East Northern Virginia region. This opens the Create Stack wizard and loads sample template 4. On the Select Template page, give the stack a name. This example uses WFE. In the Provide a Template URL box, template4wfeserver.json for the region you chose should already be displayed. Click Continue. On the Specify Parameters page, enter the IDs that you looked up in the VPC console. You can change the defaults for most of the other parameters to match your organizational standards. Check the box labeled, "I acknowledge that this template may create IAM resources." Click Continue. For this example, you can skip the Add Tags page and click Continue. On the Review page, make sure all the information is correct. If you need to change anything, click the Edit Stack, Edit Parameters, or Edit Notification links. Then click Continue. This launches the stack creation process. Click Close. In CloudFormation Manager, you can follow the progress of stack creation by clicking the Events tab. You can update the page periodically by clicking the Refresh button. When the stack status is Create Complete, click the Outputs tab of the CloudFormation console. The NetBIOS names of the Web Front-End Servers and Elastic Load Balancer are displayed in the Value column. Record these NetBIOS names and use them to connect to your instances using Remote Desktop Protocol via your RDGW instance to verify that the configuration is correct or to perform other tasks. You've now deployed two Web Front-End Servers and an Elastic Load Balancer in the Web Front-End tier, on top of the existing Virtual Private Cloud, Network, Active Directory, Database, and Application Server infrastructure. To customize this installation, you can download the CloudFormation template and modify it to meet your requirements. The Advanced Implementation Guide tells you how. The next step in deploying a SharePoint website in the Amazon Web Services cloud is to configure the SharePoint server farm.